All right, guys, here we go. St. Patty's Day craft. This is something that you can probably do with other shapes or anything else you want. It's just an idea. We're just using a shamrock theme because St. Patty's Day. So I'm going to tell you about our materials and then we're going to get started. So I have a bin. You can use something flat if possible, like a baking sheet or a cake pan or, you know, something like that. Box, small box. We just did a layer of shaving cream in there. So that's that guy. It smells nice and fresh in here right now. We also have some paper that we drew shamrocks on and then we cut them out. If you're worried about drawing the shamrocks, an easy little trick is just draw three hearts that connect at that point right there and then the little tail. Go ahead and cut that out. I have two different colors of green paint. You can do more than that if you want, but you just don't want to add too much paint because we want to have some nice swirls, and I'll explain more about that in a bit. I've got a little cloth in case our hands get dirty. I've got a paper plate to place our shamrock on after we've dipped it in our shaving cream. Make sure you have a surface that you're not too worried about getting paint on. I just have cardboard boxes. That's what I usually use. And then I've got some plastic wrap, and I made a little scraper out of a piece of cardboard. You can use an old gift card, if you have a squeegee, anything just like with a flat surface that you can scrape across. So we're gonna show you how to do this, and this is what we're gonna end up with. Marbled shamrocks, and then use them to decorate your house with, just to cheer you up. Make cards out of them, send them out, hand them out to people, whatever you want to do. So, like I said, what we did is we did put a layer of the shaving cream in here. Then we're going to take our two paints. This is just regular acrylic paint that I got from Michael's. A couple bucks, a tube. I'm just going to do a couple swirls or zigzags of the first color. Now you don't need a lot. Okay. So just something like that. Second color, just gonna kind of go in the spots that are still white. Just a couple zigzags. Like I said, not a lot. Now the material I didn't tell you about that we need is something to stir it with. I'm just gonna use a pencil because we have a million of them. You can use anything like the bottom of a plastic knife or just anything that you can stir with. So I'm going to take my pencil, I'm going to take my eraser in because this part's sharpened, and you're just going to do some swirls in the shaving cream with the paint to kind of give it a little bit of a swirl effect. So I might go this way because I did my zigzags with the paint the other way. It's kind of cool. And just kind of go until you feel like you want to stop. Don't mix it too much because then you won't get the fun patterns in there. So drag that out a little bit and just make sure your surface is as big as the shamrock that you cut out. So I'm going to go ahead and set this over here. So now we're going to take our shamrock and you're going to very lightly just lay it, the surface that you want painted, lay it on your shaving cream and your paint. And then just start to very lightly kind of push it in there. You don't have to push it deep in, just enough where you feel like each part of that paper is touching the shaving cream and the paint. Okay, and you don't even need to let it sit for that long. I'm gonna go back to my pencil to help me get it out. So since my end is sharpened, I'm going to use that. If you want to like grab a toothpick or something that you can kind of get under there to help lift it, go ahead and grab that. So I'm just going to, you can see it's right in there, and I'm just going to go and lift it up. I'm going to lift it up by the top instead of the stem because the stem is smaller and I don't want to risk ripping it. So I'm going to get it started, and then I'm going to go in here and grab it. So that's what it looks like right now. I'm going to lay it backside down on the paper plate. Okay. Now, this is still kind of got a pattern to it, so you might be able to get a few more out of that one. I'm just gonna get that out of the way. Now I've got my shamrock on my plate. I'm gonna go ahead and grab some plastic. You could probably use a plastic bag. Cut a baggie. I've got plastic wrap here I'm gonna use. Like I said, just trying to use the stuff I have around the house and just make it big enough to fit over that shamrock. I'm gonna lay it very lightly down. Okay, I can get it unraveled here. So I'm gonna just lay it right there. Now this is where we're just gonna scrape off the excess shaving cream. And that's where this little guy comes into play. So here we go. I'm just scraping very lightly, just enough to get it off of there. If you dig the corners in or you dig the sides in, it's just gonna create some lines in that shamrock, so depends on if you want them. Just try and go lightly. Just, you can go over it a few different times. All right. I'm gonna set that aside. I'm gonna peel that plastic off. Lay that over there. Show you what I'm left with. So that's what we've got right now. I'm gonna leave it to dry, and then after it's dry, I'll come back and show you what it looks like.